Hey everybody, I'm Brandon72Mo. This is the Enis Windsor, and I'm about to find out if it'll off-road. This is actually the third most voted for vehicle this week, coming in with an even dozen votes. You'll see the first most voted for vehicle later on. The reason I didn't do first and second is because, well, they're both bicycles. And I thought it'd be nice to mix it up with a bicycle and a car. So next week we'll see second and fourth place. But we are off on our ascent in the Enis Windsor. We've previously done the Enis Windsor drop. They're not quite the same car. Very similar characteristics, but they definitely do handle a little bit differently. The Enis Windsor, in either variation, is basically Enis's version of a muscle car. I mean, not only does it make a nice noise and rumble down the road, but it has a wonderful tendency, like muscle cars, to convert its rear tires into smoke, which could be a liability when you're off-roading, especially in a car this heavy. If all it wants to do is spin its wheels, that could be a problem. The Enis Windsor also likes to hang its tail out quite a bit, as we've already seen several times. So we're going to see a lot of wheel spin and a lot of shaking and shimmying around, but the nice thing about this car is if it gets into trouble and stops moving forward due to wheel spin, it does have enough low-end grunt, as we can see here, to propel it forward even on an incline if you're very careful on the throttle and you won't spin the wheels, and it will have enough power to go forward again. So, though, of course, there is a massive amount of wheel spin as someone is flying around in a Rocket Voltic. I just see the icon there on the map. Don't know who it is. I did learn something, though, this weekend recording the Will It Off-Road footage, and that's, I gotta stop letting so many people into the lobby when I'm recording. Everybody always wants an invite to hang out and play, but just too many distractions. Not for me, but in the middle of recording this car, somebody started one of the free mode events, which is fine. You know, he's in the lobby, he has every right to start a free mode event. But that puts a massive banner all across the screen saying that somebody has started it. And it's just, it's distracting for the video and for you guys that are watching. And later on, we'll see somebody running around. I don't know why he was running around, but he's literally running around in circles. And again, it's just a visual distraction that takes away from the car. And that's why we're here. We're here to talk about the vehicles. Not me, not the people in the lobby with me. We're here to talk about the cars, whether or not they'll off-road. So I think I'm just going to go back to only having Commander and Rocket in the lobby with me. And any Patreon supporters who may happen to be online if they want to be on. But yeah, I had to deal with people typing. Because they don't like using their microphones or don't have a microphone. The text coming up on the screen just kept ruining my recordings. And again, I don't blame any of these guys. It's not their fault. I should just know better than to just say, yeah, sure, everybody can join. I did this in a closed crew lobby, so everybody that's in our crew was joining. It was about an hour before a live stream, so they thought we were there for the live stream. So totally my fault, but lesson learned. But the Enis has done very well, but here comes its challenge. It has a long wheelbase. And as you can see, it gets hung up on those rocks. It was dragging towards the middle side of the car and just wouldn't give it enough. It was pulling the back wheels up off the ground. So we're going to try again, and it bounced to the right over that first bump and kind of sealed the deal here. So we're going to have to get off these rocks, which involved just kind of rocking it until I could reverse very carefully, because if I reverse too fast, I will go flying off that cliff right there. So go back one more time, try to line it up a little bit better, so if it does bounce again, it'll bounce in the direction I want it to go, and then see if we can't get up the hill. A little bit of wheel spin, but not too bad. Up and over this big bump, and we are up in 4 minutes 13 seconds. Will the Enis Windsor off-road? Yes. Though again, like a lot of cars, not really recommended. Just doesn't have ground clearance, the wheelbase is an issue, and the traction. But that means we now have to take it back down Mount Chiliad in the midst of darkness. I actually had to re-record this section because I was about three quarters of the way down when that free mode event began, and I just felt like it was just too much of an on-screen distraction to leave in the video. So I drove it back to the top and started again, and it was pitch black dark by the time I got there. So be it. See, like there, that's fine. Taco's just kind of hanging out in the background. Not really doing anything, he's just there. That type of stuff, I don't think is too big of a distraction. You know, some onlookers, some people following me up the mountain in their own vehicles, that's fine. But later on, there's going to be a jet flying around, and there's just the constant noise of a jet. Especially when I was testing a bicycle. And so the bikes don't really make a lot of noise, so that jet was just an ever-present sound. Lesson learned. But the Enos Windsor is what we're here to talk about, and I haven't spent much time talking about it. It does fine off-road. I mean, somebody asked me recently, what's the point of this series if nearly every vehicle can make it? They thought that when I first started it, that it was going to turn out that a lot of vehicles couldn't. And no, that's not the point. The point is to see what the liabilities and what the strengths are in each vehicle in an off-road setting, especially in a hill climbing off-road setting. I don't really take it to too much rock crawling. There's really no big boulders that we have to go over. There is that final rock face on the ascent that presents a challenge to a lot of vehicles, so that does give us some idea how it handles the slippery rocks. But no, this is more about just finding out, you know, if you're stuck in a situation where you have to go up and over a mountain, maybe to get away from somebody or to get away from the cops, are you in a vehicle that can handle it? And is it one that's going to handle it well? Or are you going to have some problems? And, you know, from the testing standpoint, I think it's good to know how each vehicle responds in the dirt, in the hills, in uneven pavement, over big bumps at speed. And plus, it's just kind of fun. I like off-roading in the game, and it's a lot of fun to test the different vehicles. And the Enos Windsor does okay, but as you can see, the big bumps do kind of send it bouncing just a little bit. And of course, there is that issue with traction. If this thing could get a spoiler, I think it would be a lot better. It could get some serious straight line speed, but oh, as we slide, I had a little too much straight line speed there. Back up onto the trail. It just doesn't have the best traction. And again, that's just because this thing has torque to burn. Which torque is nothing but the rotational force of the wheels. It's independent of horsepower. It is its own measurement. The horsepower is determined by torque, but not the other way around. But we're back down on pavement. I'm just trying to take it easy here. Got a little bit out of control, but we are down in 3:08, which means taking it back to the top of Mount Chiliad for a damage descent to see what type of damage it can withstand. And by the way, that brings me to another thing. With the counter on the screen, I see that I still don't have the words in the counter lined up since I moved them. Every week I move it a little bit more, the words. The counter's where it needs to be. I'll eventually get the words lined up. But they're two separate overlays on the video, so they don't have the same spatial dimensions in Adobe. So I have to kind of eyeball it because there's no grid. And I'm getting there. It's closer this week than it was before, so. Anyway, somebody asked me why the counter counts in seconds and doesn't count in tenth of seconds. You notice that it goes to 60 if you would happen to pause the video. It only counts from 0 to 60 in that final bit of the counter. That is because of the way Adobe's time code works. That last set of numbers is not milliseconds. So it's, you know, 0.1 is not a tenth of a second. 0.1 indicates 10 frames. Because I recorded 60 frames per second as I beautifully go between those trees. That was excellent. That was well done. But since I recorded 60 frames per second, every frame is being counted. So you're seeing them tick by. And then, of course, when it gets 60 frames, that's 1 second. It is actually an accurate clock. It's just to find out tenths of seconds, you have to take that number of frames and convert it into actual time. which is, I think, you either multiply or divide. I can't remember how to change frames into seconds at this particular moment. But yeah, that's the story there, why it goes to 6. Somebody asked, so I figured I'd explain it. But we are up, coming around the woodpile. This thing is taking a beating. We're up in a minute, almost 56 seconds. Let's take a look at this very long list of damage. The headlights and one reverse light are gone. Most of the windows are gone. The hood, the front bumper, the fenders, the trunk, the right door are all gone. The left door is misaligned, has moderate body denting, and it has ever so slightly bent wheels, so that one's not so slight. But that brings us to our next vehicle, which is the first most voted for vehicle this week. The Whippet Race Bike, coming in with 17 votes by one of the biggest fans of this series, whose name I can never pronounce, so I'm not going to try to butcher it. He takes advantage of the voting for the vehicles he wants to see, which is fine. I've said it before, people think I'm just joking around. If there's something you really want to see me test in Will It Off-Road, go to the form and either select it, and if it's not there, write it in at the very bottom of the list, and then vote over and over and over again, and you'll get to see that vehicle featured. I figure if somebody is willing to invest the time, I owe it to them to test that vehicle. But we're on the ascent with the Whippet Race Bike, and between this and the bike that you'll see next week, I recorded them back to back. And let's just say my right thumb from smashing the A button now has a little six pack. I mean, it got to work out. My thumb was tired. Even at the times you see me not pedaling, which you'll see more on the descents, I was still smashing A to keep the thing going as fast as it could. There was no coasting involved. And even when he slows, Beacon here slows down his pedaling, I was still smashing it as quickly as I could. Over and over and over and over and over again. There goes the jet. Lesson learned. So, the bike we'll see next week is actually a bit of a personal history for me, but I'll go ahead and tell you a little bit of the story now. When I first got GTA 5 on Xbox 360, and I got it the night it came out, I went to GameStop, waited in line at midnight because I had pre-purchased my copy, and I was at home by 12:05 because I live just blocks from a GameStop. I was at home at 12:05 playing GTA, and I had the next day off work, so you can imagine what I did. And when I started seeing that there were paths on the mountain, at the time, I didn't think a car would be able to make it up, and I know better now. So I went and found a bicycle and stole it from whoever was riding it, and then rode it up the mountain and back down the mountain and nearly got killed by a mountain lion. Just to see what was up here and just to kind of go exploring the mountains, because I thought it was really cool. So this is actually the first place in GTA 5 that I really explored, if I can talk. So I have a lot of history on this mountain, and it's somewhere that I continue to go. We go over this mountain, or at least we used to. We don't anymore. But the way we used to do the Insurgents set up for Humane Labs, we used to go up and over the mountain to avoid Meriwether until Meriwether started driving up and over the mountain too. So I just have a ton of history on this mountain. You guys thought it was for just Will It Off-Road. Nope. Nope. But if you've watched my live streams, you've seen that I've even made a race out of this very course so people can race each other up my Will It Off-Road course. We did it in just this past Saturday's live stream, in fact, in Sedans. And I was in first for a long time until that corner that we just went around when I drove my Shafter V12 off the side and Commander Hobo took first from me. I made a mistake and he took advantage of it. But the bicycles are actually pretty easy to get up the mountain. There's no wheel spin involved. As long as you can just keep hitting the A button or whatever button it is on mouse and keyboard shift to run, you have to tap it to keep him pedaling. But as long as you can do that, I'm pretty sure every bicycle can get up the mountain. Not in the quickest manner, but it is nice and peaceful because there's no engine noise, there's no wheel spin noise, just every once in a while the clunk of the bike and the sound of a jet in the air in this case. But it's kind of a peaceful way to go up Mount Chiliad. It can be really relaxing. But this bike is having absolutely no trouble whatsoever under its GTA Online character power. I was going to say human power. They're kind of human, but They are video game characters, so, you know, we can't say that they're too human. Especially considering the fact that, you know, they come back to life how many thousands and millions of times? Yeah, who knows. We're coming up the rock face. Not a challenge for a bicycle at all. It just takes a while, that's all, because it doesn't have an engine. Up and over the final rocks, and we're up. 4 minutes, 8 seconds. So will it off-road? Yep. The Whippet race bike will indeed off-road, even though it's not, doesn't look like it's designed to be like a hybrid type or a dirt bike. It'll still do it. Doesn't really matter. Those skinny tires are just fine. And since I couldn't rev the engine, I rang the bell. Not sure how loud that came through in the video, but I do like the bells on the bicycles. Oops, a little bit to the left there, but not a big deal. We're on a bike. Almost screwed up here, though. That was almost bad. So bouncing down was a big deal after all. But we're back down the mountain in a controlled descent, and again, I'm just smashing the A button for speed, and then once I get to a speed I'm comfortable with, I coast. Because the bikes don't have the strongest brakes. If you're going at really, really top speed and downhill, well, there's only so much that those friction brake pads can do. But it can go a lot faster proportionally than a car, you know, as far as its top speed and how much speed you have that the vehicle's capable of. I'm definitely pushing this bike closer to its limits than I ever would any of the actual, like, motorized vehicles that I take up and down the mountain. I do also have some other history with bicycles in GTA Online. When I first started playing GTA Online now, what, 2-3 years ago, I didn't know anybody yet, but I did want to get my stats up because I did know that if you had stamina, you could run longer and eventually run indefinitely without getting worn out. And if you had strength, you'd be better in a fist fight. And I needed to get my shooting skill and flying skill up and all of that. So I went for stamina first since I had no money and nobody to really play with. And so I would go into a lobby. Oh, took a biker out with a bicycle. Well done. But I would go into a lobby. I would get on the bicycle. And I would ride until my character's stamina ran out. Then I would just let him coast for a minute until he caught his breath. And then I'd ride again. And went from no stamina on a like level 2 character. Oh gosh, almost go off the side here. Saved by the rock. A level 2 character maxed out my stamina in one afternoon. I believe that was on a BMX that I did that. Still had that BMX, by the way. It transferred from 360. I gotta say, these bikes were a challenge not to ride, but to find. There's a glitch right now. I don't know if it's affecting everybody or just me. But my bicycles, and I do own quite a few bicycles in the game. I know they're in the garage doors. But I do own a few bicycles in the game. They're not showing up when you go into your garages where they're supposed to be on the bike racks. They're just not there, but if you walk up to the bike rack, you'll get the prompt to press right on the D-pad to use this bicycle, and you ride out. So I've literally been having to go in and figure out which bikes are in which garages. It turns out I didn't own this one, so I had to buy it. Eh, 10 grand. It's not that big of a deal. Spend more on a good paint job on some of the cars I've had to test for this series, so 10 grand's nothing. But the Whippet race bike has done fine in its descent. Down in 3 minutes, 13 seconds. Gravity helped it get there much faster, and that's just kind of ridiculous having a jet go down the highway. That means it's time for the damage descent and what is most likely suicide. I've only ever gotten, I think, 1 2-wheeled vehicle down without a death, because it's all about the landing, and if you can't nail the landings, and even if you can nail the landings, you may still get thrown off. You can see I'm trying to wheelie, but it failed. Ow, what a way to die. And that was not my bicycle exploding. Don't worry. That was the jet exploding. But very glad it didn't land on my bicycle. I would have been very, very annoyed by that. Problem now is my bike's uphill from where I am. And this is still a very steep section of the mountain. As you can see, Beacon is having a great deal of difficulty going up. I mean, look how steep. That's near vertical. And to think, I throw cars down this. But, gonna try to use the run and jump method first. And when that fails, I'll finally remember that there's a better way to do this. Just wait for it. Just wait for it. I know you're probably all shouting at the screen right now what to do. Well, I'm gonna figure it out. There we go. Get a gun and aim it. But even that, I still stumbled. Found my footing. And up we go. I love that trick. That you can aim a gun up the hill and you can walk up almost any incline. The bicycle is currently backwards, so we gotta turn it around as we glitch out on, for some reason, on the side of the mountain. And hopefully that was our only death. Ooh, there's blood. That must be where I splatted earlier and right into another rock. But this one, for some magical reason, GTA physics, thank you, we're able to get up and over that rock. Just by pedaling. Neat. So we're going to continue the downhill ascent. I am going quite quickly. There's the blown up jet glitching out in a tree and making a very strange noise. But I am pedaling quite a bit and quite furiously by pressing the A button. It's just because it's already at its top speed, it doesn't do the pedaling animation. It's just one of those weird things. Just like you can rev a motorcycle engine when you're sitting on it relaxed. I don't know if you ever noticed that, but change your biker, your MC riding style sometimes to relaxed. And then wait for your character to get over that relaxed pose, as I totally miss where I was headed. And then rev the engine, and you'll see that hands-free, your character revs the engine. I guess telepathy. Telepathy controls for cars. That's what I want. But we are down in our damage descent. 2 minutes, 43 seconds. So let's take a look at the damage. The bike itself, none. The rider, however, was dead from countless broken bones, major organ damage, internal bleeding, severe head trauma, and significantly bruised dignity. Hey, if you enjoyed this video, you know what to do. Hit that like button, get subscribed if you haven't already, and leave a comment down below. I'm Brendan72Mo, and I'll see you in the next video.